Apostle Ricard back again with another impromptu video. I want to say all praises to Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shad, okay? And Shalom, call of the elect, Akim of the elect. I'm going to entitle this video, it's just going to be a little quick impromptu. I'm going to entitle this video, We Must Be in the Spirit of Hate, okay? Because right now, that's the spirit that's coming down, man. That complete spirit of hate. These devils, these Edomites, and other nations, more than ever now, like this guy Trump got in the office, which he's a clown, he was set up, but he got these Edomites, this guy Trump, when he came back in, I mean, he was an actor, but he got these Edomites all wound up again, man. Because for a while, for the past decade or so, it was like a jaked out time. You know, Jake was running things. Okay, you had all these Edomites trying to beat Jake or trying to be like Jake. Okay, all these so-called little white women going with so-called black men and Hispanic men and Native American men. You know what I mean? The so-called white women trying to be just like the black woman. So these so-called crackers, they felt like, as they always say, which is bullshit. Well, in the way, they are the minority. We're really the majority. So really, Esau is the minority. Because there's more Israelites on this planet than any other nation. But anyways, you know, these Edomites, they felt like they had to take a back seat to Israel, to our people. But then when this dude Trump got in the office, he brought back that old rowdy, so-called redneck type spirit and got these Edomites all wound up. Now more than ever, these goddamn crackers, they in that spirit of hate. They like, oh, these niggas, these nasty right? Trump is right. These Mexicans, yeah, that's right. These so-called cops, these Edomite cops, for the past 2 years, 3 years, they just, when you go on YouTube, you go on Facebook, they got nothing but videos of the cops beating down Jake, arresting Jake. My woman was showing me something on her Facebook thing today of somewhere in New York. It had to be somewhere in New York. You know, these two undercover cops, detectives, they rolled up on this Jake and said, oh, he had a knife on him, and the Jake didn't have nothing on him, and the cop just started punching him in the face, beating him up. Then the other cops came, and there was damn Puerto Rican and black cops involved in that, too. You damn, that's why you niggas and you Puerto Ricans and you tribes that become cops, you ain't nothing but demons and sellouts, man. Okay? But anyways, man, the cops, they just beating Jake down, shooting Jake. So they in that spirit of, hey, these cops, them demons are heightened in them right now, man. They itching to shoot a nigga or beat a nigga down or a Hispanic. So they in the spirit of hate. So we're supposed to be in that same spirit of hate. Things have to be intensified. Everything is intensified now, man. Everything's intensified, man. So that's why we got to be more in the spirit of pushing the word out, man. That's all we say. Push the word and pray unto the Lord. Okay? And we can't be in no docile fucking cotton candy spirit either, man. The scripture says, man, hate the evil and love the good. It says that in the scriptures. Okay? The Most High said, I am angry with the wicked every day. And anger is another form of hate. Because when you're real angry at something, you hate it. You despise it, man. So every single day, the Most High, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, they look down and they can't wait to destroy this wicked-ass place. And going back to Romans 9 and 13 again. What does it say? As it is written, the Most High hates. And people want to say, well, why do you hate? It's wrong to hate. Well, the Bible says you're supposed to hate. Okay? King David said what? Do not I hate them with a perfect hatred. Okay? David said that in the scriptures. So it says it. Do not I hate them with a perfect hatred. Who? The enemies of the Lord, which were primarily the other nations, the so-called white man and all these other nations, the Chinese, the Japanese, the East Indians, the Africans, the Arabs, the Assyrians, these East Indians, Elam, you're supposed to hate, or Japheth, you're supposed to hate them. You're supposed to despise your enemies because they were created to be our enemies, man, and they hate the hell out of us. Romans 9 and 13. The scriptures, it says, as it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. It's in the Bible. So the next time people want to know about, well, what do you mean we have to be in the spirit of hate? The Most High is in the spirit of hate. Look at what's going on. And also, too, the Most High hates the two-thirds of Israel. That's why he's going to destroy them. You don't destroy people that you love. Okay? Look at these natural disasters, these earthquakes, these floods. A couple of weeks ago down in Baltimore, the Most High caused floods to go through there. And a lot of people got jacked up. And we're in hurricane season now. And for the past couple of years, these hurricane after hurricane, people get died. Their homes destroyed. That's hate. So the Most High and the angels are in that spirit of hate. That's why they bring in these different natural disasters and these destructions. And you watch what's going to come this summer, man. And a lot more people are going to get put to death. So we're supposed to be in that same spirit, intensifying our hate towards these devils by pushing this word out. Because that's a form of showing hate to Esau as well. Pushing the word out, man. Condemning them with the word of the Most High, which is the scriptures. Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, man. Okay? The Most High hates these devils. So we're supposed to look at these devils with pure hate. They're our enemies, man. And the other nations. And in Malachi, the Lord said, Paul, the Apostle Paul, was quoting the scripture in Malachi where the Most High said he hated Esau, man. So we're supposed to look at these devils with contempt because they look at us with contempt. And the scriptures tell us we're supposed to look at them with contempt and look at this world with contempt. Anything of the world, which also too, two-thirds of our people, we're supposed to hate them too, these wicked, evil-ass niggas. That's why it says, Amos 9 and 10, what's going to happen to them? All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. The sword represents the destruction, whether it be the cops killing them, whether it be a tornado, but ultimately it's going to be the missiles, man. Them intercontinental ballistic missiles that's going to be shot from Russia and the other enemies of America on this place. And they're going to shoot missiles back. And they're going to hit Russia and they're going to hit China. All these, it's going to be an all-out nuclear war, the third world's war, which is what we're waiting for, according to the scriptures, man. So we're supposed to be in the proper spirit, man. We can't be walking around here in a docile spirit. We got to be in the total spirit of hate for this whole world, man. I read the scripture in a video I did earlier, Amos 9 and 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord Yahweh are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth. So the Most High looks down on this church with hate. So the Most High and Yahweh shines in that spirit. So we're supposed to be in the same spirit, man, of hate for this world and our enemies, man. Anything or anybody that's contrary to the doctrine of Yahweh Shai. Okay, that's the spirit that we're supposed to be in, man. That's the right spirit. That's the proper spirit. So with that, I'm going to wrap it up real quick. All right, this is Apostle Ricard. Say shalom to all the Akim of the elect. Shalom.